Agree to says, in the name of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, shall we pray. Heavenly Father, we love and appreciate you. We thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for protecting us. And Father, at all times, Lord, putting us under your shield of armor. As we enter this day, Lord Jesus Christ, we pray that you continue doing so. Once more, we pray that no harm nor danger may come our way. In the wonderful name we pray. Amen. Saints, I greet you once again. Beloved, we're reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 18. But those things which proceedeth out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile a man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashed hand does not defile a man. Amen. Our second reading, brothers and sisters, will be on the book of Mark, chapter 13. We will read the verse. Amen. We will read verse 8. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be earthquakes in various places, and there will be famines and troubles. These are the beginnings of sorrows. Amen. I greet you, brothers and sisters, once more this hour in the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We are grateful once more for the opportunity that the Lord has given us, once more giving us an opportunity to be witnesses of His love, to be witnesses once more of Him speaking to us this hour through Malachi 4, giving us the gift of life, that only Him, He is the author. We are grateful unto the Lord. We do not take that for granted. Amen. Last time we spoke, brothers and sisters, about the garden. Amen. The garden of our daily living. Hallelujah. Now, we are realizing that the scripture is telling us that the heart harbors a lot of things. Amen. The heart is harboring blasphemy. The heart is harboring idolatry. The heart is harboring a lot of things that are contrary to what the Lord requires of us. Hallelujah. It is for that reason then, when we are planting our daily seed, our daily garden, our planting of our daily living garden, it is to enable us, it is to enable our hearts to produce things that are fruits of the Spirit. It enables us to produce things that are pleasing in the eyes of the Lord. Now, we are grateful, brothers and sisters, that by revelation today, we have an understanding of what is that God is expecting of us. That Prophet Paul teaches us that because the Lord has made His will known to us, hallelujah, He has made His will known to us today by revealing His word to us. He has spoken to us through Malachi 4. We know what His will is for us. His will for us is to be His sons and daughters, manifested in the end time. Hallelujah. Now, we are learning, brothers, that in order for us to be able to understand what is expected of us, the prophet is teaching us that the natural types the spiritual. Things that happen in the natural are things that should happen in the spiritual. Amen. Now, a man by the name of Paulo Coelho says, what is success? It is being able to go to bed each night with your soul at peace. Hallelujah. Now, our success in business, our challenges in life, our troubles with our children, our troubles with our spouses, our troubles with our families are not a measure of how close or how far we are from God. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible says, all worketh good for them that love the Lord. Now, what that is teaching us, it is teaching us that through those experiences, whether positive, whether negative, there is a good in it. There is a purpose that it is served. Hallelujah. Now, we learn that a shepherd, when there's a sheep that likes to do things and not follow the rest of the flock, the prophet teaches us that the shepherd will take the sheep and break its leg in order to have it close to him, in order he can be able to give it more attention. Now, the challenges that we are facing in our personal lives, the challenges that we are facing in our professional lives, we have to see the good in them, because nothing happens by mistake. Amen. Therefore, in our daily living, we should be able, brothers and sisters, to ensure that whatever the outcome is, whatever it is that we are experiencing, our souls are at peace. Hallelujah. Our souls are at peace. Meaning, therefore, that we should stray away from wrong thoughts. We should stay away from anything that is contrary to Scripture, because that which is contrary to Scripture is what will defile our bodies. Have you ever experienced a situation where there is something nagging within you? You have no idea what it is, but you can feel that you have a heavy heart. And then you track back, and then you realize that you answered a particular person in an unbecoming manner, or you addressed a particular situation in an unbecoming manner. And until you go back to that person and make things right, then you will only then find relief. It is the same thing with us and God, that God loves a repentant heart, that whenever we stray away from God, we ought to come back to him and seek his counsel. We ought to come back to him and have him forgive us of whatever we have done. For the prophet is teaching us, brothers and sisters, that salvation is an individual affair between every person and God, not with our nation, with our church, but with God, with ourselves before God. Hallelujah. So whenever we find ourselves going astray, we should go back to God and seek his counsel, and that he may forgive us. Hallelujah. Now we are realizing, brothers and sisters, that what we have experienced as a country in the past weekend, with the inclement weather in Port Elizabeth, with the inclement weather here in Tonga, right in front of our eyes, the scripture is teaching us that these things are going to happen right before the end. Hallelujah. Now, we are realizing, brothers and sisters, that these things are a sign. The Lord taught us that I come at an hour that nobody knoweth. Hallelujah. Nobody anticipated in their wildest dream that we could be finding ourselves in the situation we are at now. all of these things happened so abruptly. We were expecting this bad weather, but it was being directed towards the south coast. And yet, within a twinkling of an eye, within a split second, a whirlwind, a tornado raptured and destroyed almost everything. Now, we learned that natural types spiritual. Now, it is the same thing with God. We ought to be expecting Him at any given time. Many people have died. Nobody thought that they would be facing that situation this morning. Nobody thought that this is the turmoil that our city would find itself in. But you see, you and I are privileged. You and I are privileged because we are under the blood of Jesus Christ. He has saved us. When all these things were happening, He protected us. When everything was going upside down, He tucked us under His shield of armor. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, this morning, I want us to remember that God loves us. Hallelujah. Unless we suffer with Him, we cannot reign with Him. We have to suffer to reign. The reason for this is that character simply is never made without suffering. Character is a victory, not a gift. Hallelujah. So in planting our daily garden of living, we ought to be able to understand that we are building that character of a stature of a perfect man. And upon attaining that stature of a perfect man, we shall be victorious. We shall realize victory. Hallelujah. We thank God, brothers and sisters, that this hour, God in us, He has found His people. He has found us that He may be able to use us. The prophet says, God has a hard time trying to get somebody that He can deal with, that will stay humble and make and stay in the place until God calls him to do something. You believe that? A man that God can bless, and he will still keep himself a man, not be an angel or a god. As soon as man gets blessed and has a little something given to him, he wants to become a god. He wants to become an angel. He wants to become some great person. What I do, me and mine, all that, that's the wrong attitude. God's hunting for somebody who He could bless and pour out the blessings, and more He blessed, the little the man will become. And you will never get more of God until you become nothing. You have got to belittle yourself. He that will exalt himself, God will bring abase. He that will humble himself, God will exalt. You've got to get little before you can get big. And you will never be big in your own self. You will only be as big as God will be big in you. Brothers and sisters, this morning, let us render ourselves living sacrifices that God can be big in us. Let us render ourselves this morning as sons and daughters of God. Let us render ourselves this morning as little children, for the Lord taught us that unless you become like a child, you shall not see the kingdom of heaven. Let us have a repenting heart. Let us have a teachable spirit. I am glad this morning that by faith we have become like little children. By faith we are His sons and daughters. By faith we understand what His will is for us. God bless you, shall we pray? Heavenly Father, once more this morning, help us, Lord, in this journey by leading and guiding us. Help us, Father, once more by showing us the way. Let it be, Lord, that we not be pompous, but we may be humble. That, Heavenly Father, by being big in us, we may be big as much as you want us to be. Forgive us of our iniquity. Forgive us of our shortcomings. Be with the families that have suffered pain during this tornado. Be with the families that have lost their loved ones. Once more, reassure them, Lord Jesus. In the wonderful name I pray, believing and trusting, what I ask in your name shall be granted. Amen.